Subscribe to Mom's Food Diary and tap on the bell icon so that you can receive my latest recipe notifications. On this channel, you will find all the delicious homemade recipes as well as amazing street food along with the restaurant reviews. So subscribe and check on the bell icon. Hello friends, welcome to Mom's Food Diary. Today I'll be showing you a very tasty fish curry made from silver perch fish, which is also known as shetka in Konkani. It's made in very traditional and authentic method using the freshly grounded masala, so it's a very tasty fish curry. So let's prepare the fish curry recipe. So this is the fish I was talking about. This is known as silver perch and known as shetka or shetuk in Konkani in Karwar. So this is a fish which is silver perch. So we need around 500 grams of that. So this is the red chilli known as bedgi. So we need 8 of this chilli and we need coriander seeds about 2 tablespoons and the desi red chilli we need 5 pieces. Along with that we will be needing onions 2 chopped. So we have grated half of the coconut and this is the dried mango pieces 4 to 5 or you can add 1 lemon juice. As I was saying, this is the half grated coconut. We need 1 spoon of turmeric powder, one bulb of garlic, salt as per taste. Also we need green chilies to flavor the recipe. Also it removes the fish smell. We need 8 to 10 green chilies and water sufficient to grind the masala. So these are the ingredients of the recipe. It's very tasty fish curry. So initially what we'll do is in a mixer jar we will add both the red chilies, the desi and the bedgi one, because it gives authentic taste to the recipe. So along with coriander seeds, grated coconut, garlic, turmeric powder and water, we need to grind it to a fine paste. Please try this recipe because it turns out very delicious because it is made in an authentic traditional way. So we will grind it to a fine paste. We will add a little water and need to grind it. As you can see, we have grinded the masala now. Now what we will do is we will add the onion pieces and the dried mango pieces and again we will grind it. So we have cut the green chilies through the middle because it gives the flavor into the curry. So in a vessel we have added the masala. We have to add water sufficient for the curry. You shouldn't add more or less water, it should be like sufficient and on full flame. Below flame will be full and we need to add salt, green chilies and we have to mix it well. We need to stir it until it starts boiling. As you can see, it has started boiling. When it starts boiling, we need to make the flame to slow and cook for 5 more minutes and then we need to turn the flame to full and we need to add the fish pieces into the curry. So we have cleaned the fish and washed it thoroughly and now we will be adding the fish into the curry vessel. Once we added the fish, we need to make sure you do not stir it strongly, but you need to just touch the base because the fish might get broken into pieces. That's why we do not stir it thoroughly. Once you have added fish, we need to cook for 3 minutes and the fish curry will be completely ready on full flame. So we have taken it off. So as you can see, don't open it until 5 minutes. Keep the lid closed. Once it is taken off stove, our tasty fish curry is completely ready. Serve this with rice, roti or chapati. It's very tasty, authentic recipe. Thank you for watching. Have a nice day.